Hello and welcome to this video. Today I show you how to install the Luma 3DS custom firmware on your 3DS with the old 3DS web browser exploit. So this works with all of the old 3DS consoles, the old 3DS, the old 3DS XL, and the old 2DS. It won't work with the new 3DS, new 3DS, or new 2DS XL. This option is one of two options. You can either use an exploit in the system update option, but that doesn't work with all of the providers, or you can use the stat packs. If your 3DS version is 11.14.0, you can check the version on the top screen in the system settings. So first we can download this release file. We can simply save it and then open it. Here we can go into the folder for your, or you can go into the folder for your region, in my case it's Europe, and then I can extract all of this stuff to the SD card. In my case I have to replace it, you probably won't have to replace it. Next we can download the homebrew menu. All of the downloads will be linked in the description, so you can find the links there. And we can download the boot.3sx file and extract it to the SD card as well. We can download boot9strap. Both of these files have to be copied into a boot9strap folder on the SD card, so we'll have to create a new folder and have to call it boot9strap, and then we can copy the files into it. Next, we can download the Luma 3DS custom firmware. We can download the archive and extract the boot.firm file to the SD card. We can download the universal other app.bin file and copy that to the SD card. You will have an ARM11 code.bin file on the SD, so we have to delete that, and we have to rename the other app.bin file to ARM11 code.bin. And this might be a bit problematic if your operating system hides the file extensions. So if you don't have these .bin endings and stuff like that, you have to Google on how to enable them in order to avoid mistakes. Next, we can download this archive, the save b9s installer, and we can copy the save b9s installer.bin file to the SD card. And last of all, we have a QR code. You can either type a URL into the browser, I will show that, or you can scan this QR code, and then you don't have to type the URL. But now everything is copied to the SD card, and we can switch to the 3DS. Here we are again. You can either press both shoulder buttons, the left and the right one, and then you will get to a camera mode where you can activate a QR code scanner. Then you can scan the QR code, or you can go into the web browser and type in the URL manually. So I will select URL, and here I can change this to HTTPS. And then we will have to go to Azugi, but I will have to type that correctly, .github.io/web. /nbhex. Let me check that I wrote everything correctly. It looks good, so I can confirm that. We can allow the website, and now you can press on proceed to hex, and you can press A, and you can press A again. Now we will boot into the boot9strap installer. It's possible that it won't work for you. In that case, please check the comments where I will pin a comment with solutions for some problems that might help you, or you can feel free to ask them if it still doesn't work. But now we can follow the instructions on the top screen, so we can press the button combination. And now it will install the custom firmware. The 3DS will reboot and we will get into the screen. Here you can select some stuff depending on what you want. Both of the upper options are pretty helpful, so you should activate them. The third one is to see that you're in custom firmware. If you go into the system settings and then on the upper screen there's the system version. And normally there's ver. And then the version, and then it will be changed to sys. And then the version. So that's the third option. And now we can press the start button to save the changes. And now we have the custom firmware, but it still needs configuring. So I will link the next part, part two, in the description, and I will link it as basically everything where I can link it. So you can check that video out to configure the custom firmware and install a bit stuff into it. But that was it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching. I hope that I see you in the next part, and bye.